requires responsibility.
Come on.
Oh yes. Hello here, somebody. It does. It is a price to pay. If you want to be close to God, so many people don't want to pay that price. But see, that's what it's a price worth paying. That's what reasonable means. It's worth the price. It's worth the price.
Yes, sir.
I would pay, I'm paying the price now. People don't want. So I have a lot of people that don't talk to me no more. Don't want to be bothered. But you know, I'm just as happy as I want to be. Listen, I'm 42. I'm over you not liking me.
Yes.
Hold on here. And that's man's biggest problem. I gotta be accepted. God never called me. I'm an individual. God didn't call me to be accepted. If you're going to be what God called you to be, you can't be accepted. That's our biggest problem. I want to be liked by everybody. You need to be weary when people, oh, everybody. When anybody like you, you need to check yourself. I love God too much. And you know what? Can I say this? God commanded us to love, not to like.
That's right.
So I don't know where we get like from.
Come on.
That's you. That's carnal.
Carnal.
Not spiritual like. Do you like me? I don't care. I love you. I'm right with God. When I go to sleep at night, I'm going to be all right.
Come on.
I get sleep. I sleep good at night. You know what? Let me say, why you look so young, Elder Brown? I sleep at night. I don't have a lot of gray hairs because I don't worry about how much you don't like me. I'll be upset for like a quick 30 seconds, not even 30 seconds. I ain't going to give you that much time over my life.
Ain't worth it. You ain't worth it.
When you got to walk with God, I got news for you. You're going to have to walk away from family members. The Bible, Jesus told me, he said, a man should phone should be there of his own household. When you tell Jesus yes, you got to tell a lot of folk no.
Oh my God.
Some of you in relationships right now, God said, get out. I had to get out of one.
I got out of
a bad relationship because it wasn't fruitful and productive. Nothing was happening. I was looking for God to bless me, but God ain't going to bless nothing outside of his will.
Come on. My God.
Man, God. You stuff up in here.
Jesus. He ain't blessing nothing outside of his will. Oh, Lord, I want you to bless my ministry. You don't even have a clue what your ministry is, because if it did, you wouldn't even been doing the stuff you're doing. He was talking to this preacher right here. You're looking at a former backslider, sitting in church but backslid. Sitting on the pulpit but backslid.
Preach, man.
So I'm letting you know there's no perfect people in this room today. I know I'm not perfect, but I seek after that. God, press toward the mark. For the prize of the high calling on in Christ. I want to be like Jesus. And let me tell you something, it's going to cost you something to be like Jesus. But when it's all over, at the end of the day, it's going to be well with your soul.
That's right.
Man, I tell you, I'm not where. See, one of the problems is, can I say this? And I'm going to close out. I'm trying to close out. I want to say this to you. I want you to get this in your mind. So you got to understand, we don't think, especially those of us as African Americans, we don't think long term. We think very short term. Hell, I heard somebody say it like this. They said, life is too short and eternity is too long to be without Jesus.
That's right.
So who you hang out with now is who you going to be hanging out with later.
Amen.
And see, your later, see, you got a choice now. Later, you don't have a choice. Once he takes his people with him, it's a done deal. I call grace God, man's golden opportunity.
Amen.
That's all it is, for you to get right with God.
Yeah.
And right now, if anybody want to get right with God, it's right here, right now.
Right now.
That's what I came for. Right here, right now.
Come on.
You want God to touch your life, and you want to just say yes right here in your heart. Because we can say a lot. You know, we deceive with our lips. But if God wants to hear, see, he's looking at your heart.
Hallelujah.
If you come and say yes now, while you are halfway up, God will fill you with the Holy Ghost right there.
That's right.
Come on.
All right.
Come on.
Come on.
Make your way. Make your way.
Yeah.
Well, preacher, I don't have the right thing on. Guess what? If you don't have the Holy Ghost, you don't have the right thing in. In is more important than out.
That's right. That's right.
We ain't concerned. Ain't nobody here front on your dress code.
That's right.
We outside today.
That's
listen.
Right.
We don't care about what you got on.
Amen.
That's between you and God. Listen, God ain't that concerned about what you got on. He's concerned about the relationship that he wants to have with you. If there's one here.
Come on.
Come now.
Come on.
Man, come on.
Tomorrow is not promised.
Yeah.
Well, tomorrow, I'm coming to church tomorrow.
Yeah.
You can have an accident today and check out of here.
That's right.
hesitation is procrastination and hesitation is an enemy to any type of progress in life.
Amen.
If you want to make some progress, you got to make some right now decisions right now. Come.
Come on.
If there's one right now. That's what we out here for. We out here because of who Jesus is. Is there one? God bless you. May heaven smile upon you. God bless you, and I'm praying for you. Can I have a prayer? Can I just pray over you?
Yes.
Father, in the name of your son, Jesus Christ, I come right now. Because God, you said in your word,
yes,
one planteth, one watereth, but you give the increase.
Yes.
We're looking for the increase. We did it like you asked us to do. We did it as under your leading and under the unction of your spirit.
Yes.
God, we now believe in you that the seed is planted and has been watered. And God, that you would do the rest. God, we speak into the lives of those that don't know you, God, that they will be filled with your spirit. God, have your way in their lives right now in the name of Jesus. God, somebody's struggling with addiction. We bind it right now in the name of Jesus Christ. God, we cast that demon out right now in the name of Jesus. Somebody's struggling with sexual promiscuity, God. Fornication, homosexuality. And we know these are traps that the enemy used to rob us of our identity. But we speak victory right now in the name of Jesus over those souls, God. Have your way in their lives. Remember this church, this ministry that's out here, God. Remember every last one of every speaker, God. Elder Ward, Elder Ellison, God. Remember every home that's represented in this place. God, have your way in their lives and bless them as only you can. In Jesus' name, let's give God the best praise we got. God bless you, and I love you.